find any special difficulties in carrying out this whole performance from a wheelchair?
I don't think we did, really, did we, Malcolm? I don't know. I mean, we did a lot of...
It's very nice to act when you're sitting down all the time. It really is.
Malcolm, there have been varying reports about the length of time you trained in a wheelchair for this part. Let's get to the truth of it. Is that right?
No, the truth is actually two lessons and a lot of practice at home.
Yes.
And, in fact, the wheelchairs are made actually very simply for you to use. I mean, not me, but people that have, had spinal injuries and things. And they're very easy to use, actually. And so it wasn't really difficult at all.
No, the I only didn't difficult expect it to be very difficult, but of
right,
course it's not if you're lucky enough to be able to get
well,
up
we can
and walk
get up
away
and walk away from the, afterwards and go home in a car and walk down the road, and it's all right for us,
Nanette, what were your feelings about this part? Do you feel that you captured the real agony of being a cripple?
Well, I hope I did. I obviously worked very hard at it. And, one can only hope that one did one's best.
How involved in the character, though, were you?
Well, tremendously involved. I think one always is. And I was very fortunate in having somebody like Malcolm to work with.
Well, what about working together? How often have you worked together before?
It's nice to work with friends, huh?
No. And we got on very well, and we enjoyed it. In fact, the whole film was really marvellous to make, which seems very strange when you're dealing with a subject like this. But it was a very, very happy picture.
I think it comes over, actually, in the film, if you see the film, that it's a comedy in a way, as much as about crippled people in wheelchairs. I mean, it's done with a...
tremendous sense.
Yes, the wrong word, I suppose, is a light-hearted way. I mean, it isn't really. But there's a lot of comedy in the film.
This was one of the things that all the people in the homes that we visited, because we obviously had to visit a vast number of homes, and they all said to us, please don't make us seem like depressing people who've got, this terrible thing to bear. And they all had great sense of humour. They'd come to grips with this terrifying disability. And they said, you must show the lighter side and the funny things that happen to us. And some very funny things do, in fact, happen to them, which we've tried to show some of them in the film.
Bruce, did you find yourself identifying completely with... Malcolm, rather.
Bruce, I am.
Did you find yourself identifying completely with the character of Bruce?
Well, I think if you're an actor, whatever part you do, you have to... This is one of the secrets of being an actor. I mean, you have to get in under the skin of the character and do the role totally and totally realistically, which I hope... I mean, I know Nanette has done. I hope I have in the film, and I hope it gives a true picture of what these people actually go through. I mean, it isn't, we were talking about the sense of humour in the film. I mean, it also shows the other side, the depressing side, that when the person that I play in the film is struck down by this disease, he does go into depression, but he gets out of it by meeting Jill.
Now, in just some of its aspects, this film resembles love. I say just some of its aspects, it resembles Love Story.
Mm.
Is there a comparison?
Well, as people make the comparison, I think it's unfortunate that they do, because I feel that it hurts our film, and box office-wise.
Why do you say that?
Because I think that people feel they've been cheated when they've seen Love Story. They feel that Love Story is a sentimental film playing on pure sentimentality, and it's a cheat in a way. And I found this particularly true in America, and they thought, oh, not another Love Story. God, we've had enough of that, But this is, to quote a New York Times critic, a real love story of real people. And I think that's the difference. These are not cardboard cutouts. They're actually, I hope, real people. I mean, the book, the original book, was written by a paraplegic himself. It's a very moving novel. And I think Brian's done a marvellous job on the screenplay. I really do.
Nanette, Malcolm,